This right here is my domain. Hey, Tim, come over, back me up.
You use this thing so much, like twice a week.
I love it.
Okay, but are you as good with charcoal as you are with a gas grill?
Nope.
No. Okay.
Gas only.
So charcoal, it's not all created equal, like the briquettes and the lump coal and all that kind of jazz.
Right.
So if you're gonna be like at a park or you're gonna be at a tailgate, you have to use charcoal. So Consumer Reports takes a look.
Briquettes are made primarily of sawdust and each piece has a consistent shape. So that means they burn more uniformly. Charcoal is charred wood pieces of different sizes and shapes. The labels often claim that they burn hotter and longer than briquettes.
Consumer Reports settles the rivalry with science. They burned 3 pounds each of briquettes and lump coal in two very different grills, a kettle style and a big green egg. Then they brought out the scientific instruments. Thermocouplers on the grates collected the precise temperature for each, and that info goes into a computer, which turns it into a heat distribution map. Overall, the lump charcoal burned about 40 to 50 degrees hotter than the briquettes. For evenness, the lump charcoal only got a fair score in the Weber kettle, but it got a very good score in the big green egg. And in duration tests, the big green egg lump coal maintained a low temperature of 250 degrees for 11 hours versus just 4 for those briquettes. The briquettes, though, got excellent scores for evenness in both grills, and the briquettes burned evenly throughout. The testers found lump charcoal is best for when you want a hot sear on a steak, that smoky flavor that comes from real wood, also for cooking low and slow. But
to stack, light, and control, and they're a whole lot cheaper.
Let's look at the price. The briquettes, 54 cents a pound. The lump charcoal, $1.25 per pound.